Hello everyone and welcome to episode 14 of ARK Season 1. In today's video, we're going to be going over to Ragnarok to fight the bosses over there with Templar. He invited us over to fight the Gamma bosses. He's going to be using a majority of his army, and we're going to have two of our Rexes, a male and a female, and then also one of our Deodons in the fight. Now, I have already done the fight, and I have to say, it did not go as I expected. So definitely stick around for this part. But anyways, guys, before we get into the video, I would like to ask you to please consider subscribing if you haven't already, because it really does help the channel out. And if you find yourself enjoying this video at any point, please do consider leaving a like rating. It really does help. And if you're looking for more ways to help out the channel, recommending my channel to a friend really does help. Again, I say that every video, but it really does help. So anyways, guys, let's get straight into the video. Okay, everyone, so we're gonna put all the artifacts in here. And 3, 2, and 1. Ready. Just gonna make sure that he's ready. Okay, and then we're gonna go. We're gonna get onto our Rex army. The rest of the army's coppers, but this is ours, so we're gonna put our armor on. Drink our soups. Ooh, okay. Okay, I don't have anything that's not transferable. Okay, that's good. Oh, this is scary. Let's go. Woo, let's go. First actual boss fight that's not like a titan. Yeah, let's move all the dinos. That's right, I rebound that key. Oh wow, we do severely reduced damage. 2 hours and 40 minutes sounds like a lot of time. Oh yeah, there we go, there's the damage. Okay. You have to try to get the dinos in the center here. I'm probably gonna cut around a lot, just because, like, this could take a while. Let's kill this Pteranodon. Oh, wow. This thing's gonna take some hits. Oh, shoot, where's the Deodon? It's on a passive heal, is it? No, it's not. Oh, right here. Ah, that needs to get out of here. Get it! Get it! Surround it! Oh my god, what is doing 8,000 damage? This thing's taking hits. Yeah, this thing's gonna go down. Well, okay. Can we get everything over here, please? Or you know what? Let's just whistle it onto that. Oh, dude, he's not on the Uteranus. Where is he? Yeah, I'm stuck. Oh, kill it. Kill it! No! That's the wrong thing! No! Go there. Oh, I can't get off. This Uteranus is just on me, dude. There we go. We need to get... Someone needs to be on this Uteranus. UD? where is the... I rebound my attack my target key, and I now know I need to rebind it, because it's, like, on the other side of my keyboard, and it's not good. Oh, the rock golems are gonna do a number. Get! Oh, stop! On landing. Oh wow, we do like no damage. If I can, I might want to get on that Uteranus. Oh good, the Deodon's on. Good. I don't even know where my Rex is. Okay, can we get on him? Can we get on him? Get on! Trap him! He takes reduced... That's right, the Manticore takes like 4 times reduced damage, so that would explain why we're only hitting him for 631 instead of like 3k. Or 2k, something like that. Oh, come on, man. I need to be able to shoot off the back of Rexes. I don't want to dismount. Oh, dude, is my Rex bloody? I can't tell. Like, it doesn't have a saddle. This one, Army F right here. I need to kill these rock golems. So apparently the Manticore is the hard one in this fight. Good to know. Good to know for when we eventually get around to doing the Alpha. Oh, we need to get on it. We need to get on it. Everything needs to get over here. And then everything needs to get on it. Get on it. Get on it. No! We need someone on a Uteranus. We need to be doing increased damage. How are you doing on health, buddy? I think it looks full. Nearly full, at least.
Okay. Where's the Uteranus? Yeah, I'm stuck. It's not good.
How did I get stuck like this? Where is the Uteranus? We really need that Uteranus. Dude, his Rexes are bloody. I don't think ours... I can't tell, though, because of the color. Get on it! I can't... I'm stuck. I am so stuck. How are they doing? They're doing... He's almost down. Oh, dude. No! Get on! Get on the Manticore!
Why? They shouldn't be on attack my target. Get on the Manticore! Get on the Manticore! Just follow him around! Oh my god!
Oh no, I hit the dragon corpse. Go over there. Get it.
Some of his wrecks are really bloody. Okay, get over there. Everyone, get over there.
Get on the Manticore. That's really not good. There we go. We're unstuck. Yeah, that's really not good. We need the Uteranus. I see it. I'm going for it. This could be a bad idea, but... This could be a really bad idea, but... I'm stuck. Okay. Apparently... Oh! The Manticore! Get on the Manticore! No! No! None of the Rexes went for it! Oh, this is not good.
Oh, this is really not good.
Let's get on the Uteranus! Come on! Yeah, this was really not good. It's coming in! Get it! Get it, boys! Yes! Oh no, it's out of time. Well, I mean, that lasted 9 minutes. Wow. Well, everyone, I'm gonna have to figure out what I want to do for the rest of this video, because it's probably not gonna be 9 minutes long. Okay, everyone, so we have the Manticore and the Dragon flags here, just on the outside of the base. Figured we might as well use them for decoration, as they're really not used for anything else. And then we also have the Gamma Dragon trophy here, and then the Gamma Manticore trophy right there. Now, we will, of course, be replacing them with the Alpha variants once we defeat those bosses. And right here, I think we'll have the Alpha, or the head of the dragon on this map, the Crystal Wyvern Queen. Then here we'll probably have the Brood Mother. We'll replace that with the Forest Titan and then the Ice Titan next to it. And then here we'll replace this with the monkey statue, the Megapithecus. And then, you know, I'm pretty sure those are all of the heads in the game. And then we'll probably fight the Manticore a couple more times, maybe just the Manticore by itself to get a bunch of shield skins and then dot those around as decoration. But, you know, I do think I like how this is going to work out. We need to swap that one out with something, probably find a place to put that one. But, yeah, everyone, I'm going to figure out what to do with the remaining time in this episode and also edit this video. So, yeah, I'll be back later. So, everyone, I figured for the rest of this video, we might as well go try to steal some more Wyvern Eggs. Maybe try to get a higher level one, I'm not sure. It's like our poison wyvern egg is not that high level. Does that say 180? Or that's say 18? I think that was 18. Oh, that was 30, okay. Well, anyways, I'm gonna only bring you guys back if I find a good egg. If not, I'm not even gonna use this footage. So yeah, I'll see you guys if I get a good egg. Okay, everyone, so we have an Alpha Fire Wyvern right here. There was another one that fell in the lava, and then this one just spawned in. So, I mean... Yeah, we might as well just go after it. Now, I do have an Anki down here and a turret that should, in theory, enable... Should be firing. Why is the turret not firing? Why is the turret not firing? That's not good. Yeah, that's really not good. I think it's on that guy, so if we send the... Wyvern, go! Wyvern, go! Go! See, this guy looks bloody. We might be able to kill him anyways. Yeah, we're gonna be able to kill this guy. Ooh, okay. That's dumb that the turret wouldn't fire at it. My plan was there. There. So why wouldn't the turret go after it? It's turned on. It's turned on wild creatures. Alpha Fire Wyvern. This was on... Okay, that's dumb. Well, I mean, that did not take that many bullets, either. And... I mean, we might as well just leave it here. We could set it to all wyverns, but bullets are a little expensive right now. Because it just takes a while to get the spark pattern. So we do have some more loot from this. Because, like I said earlier, there was another one that had fallen into the river, into the lava river. And I noticed it, I'm like, what? That sucks. I really would have liked to be able to kill it, and we did not get that much XP on the chibi. You would expect them to give a lot more XP. But we do have 100 Wyvern Milk now, not that we really need it, and 2 Wyvern Gloves, so, I mean, you know, that's not bad. It's really not bad. So, yeah, everyone, I'm gonna continue looking for good level eggs, and I'll bring you guys back. Well, everyone, these are the eggs that we got. All three of the eggs that can be got in the trench, and they're all 198s. So I think we're gonna hatch these up right now, and make sure the nanny is on. Okay, so the nanny's on, we're gonna hatch them up right over here. And hope that we get some decent colors from these guys, because, you know, that would be really nice. Actually, you know what, we need to put them in a hatchery. So I'm going to go get these guys in a hatchery over at our breeding area, and I'll be back. Okay, so everyone, I have the eggs here, they're all incubated, so I just need to drop this one out and it should hatch. And, you know, this is a pretty generic looking poison wyvern, to be honest, but you know, I do like the look of poison wyverns, so you know, I'm not sure how good these stats are. However, there's this handy tool with the in the dino storage mod where if we go here, we can see that it has 34 points into health, 30 into stamina, 40 into oxygen, 30 into weight, and 34 into melee damage. So basically, this guy's an oxygen, which, I mean, you know, it's fine, I guess, but really? So, he's on passive, and now let's hatch Lightning Wyvern. This is a very generic, basic-looking Lightning Wyvern. Let's check out the stats. It looks around to be the same. Honestly, let's check what this guy has. He's 40 into oxygen as well. Is 44 into melee, though. I mean, it's not bad. Certainly not bad. You can go over there. And now we have one last egg to hatch up, and it's that this fertilized fire wyvern egg. And this one, like, look at this one right here. It looks more like sand-colored, if we look at it. This looks a little lower. This looks pretty low. Food might be high. Let's check what its stat distribution is. Has 44 into weight, that's not bad. It's better than 40 into oxygen, which there's only 31 into oxygen, and then there's 28 into food, so this one's not bad either. So, you know, I have to say, these are pretty decent wyverns for their levels. I would have liked to get some higher level ones, so maybe I'll go back to the wyvern trench and see if I can find any and just show you guys the wyverns with their stats, but yeah, I like this. I'm gonna let these wyverns grow up now, and I'll bring you guys back later. Well, everyone, I think that's going to have to do it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you think you're going to enjoy what I do here, please consider subscribing if you haven't already. And if you want to help the channel out even more, consider leaving a like on this video. And if you want to help, if you want to know more ways you can help the channel, recommending my channel to a friend who might enjoy it would be very helpful. So thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.